one another. It's not that we overlook the concerns and the problems of the nation. We're not overlooking the stresses and the loss of life in the nation. We're not overlooking the need for better leadership and stronger governing bodies. But we come today, Father, and pray these prayers concerning your church and concerning this house, and believing together that what we do now, we do under your oversight, and we do under your leadership. And we are connected vitally to the Lord Jesus Christ, our shepherd, our high priest, and our intercessor. Lord, we thank you that you always live to make intercession for us. Your ears are always open to our cries. Your eyes are always beholding us, whether we are together, two or three, or whether we stand singularly. You are always with us. You vow never to leave us and never to forsake us. Father, in Jesus' name, as we come into your presence right now, we agree in our heart, we agree in our mind, we agree in our confession, and we agree in our belief and our faith. We ask in Jesus' name, examine our hearts right now, Father, and know us all together. Be familiar with our thinking and our thoughts afar off, and all that is in us. Weigh us in the balance, and should we be found wanting, we ask that you will forgive us, purge us, and cleanse us from all sin, iniquities, transgressions, and whatever it may be that is offensive to you, offensive to your Holy Spirit, offensive to the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, our desire is to please you. Our heart yearns to obey all your statutes and commandments and to do all that you have commanded us to do. We desire to be, Father, those that you have saw, looked upon as men and women after your own heart. And so we thank you today that we can gather in this place in your presence. Father, in Jesus' name, you told us to pray for those who had nothing set before them. And so we bring the hungry before you right now, in your church, in your body, Lord, those that may not have learned to walk by faith, and those that may have ignored your prodding to walk by faith and to assemble themselves in the house of God, and now find themselves in the midst of this storm, in the midst of this situation. We pray and ask you, Father, in Jesus' name, to have mercy upon us. We pray now for supernatural provision for the church and for the body of Christ. While we are grateful for the system of help that our federal government has issued out, we are mindful, Lord, that our help comes from you, that our help and our hope and our provision come from Jehovah Jireh, who is our provider. We thank you, Lord, that you by choice can use any system, any persons or group of persons to funnel your resources and blessings through in order to get them down to the proper people who are praying and believing you for it. We thank you in Jesus' name that all things are working together for our good because we love you and are called according to your purpose. So we pray and ask you, Father, to bless them with provision, bless them with food and resources. Bless them, Father, as you said in your word, that we're not to be concerned about tomorrow. It'll take concern and care for itself, that you are aware of who we are. You are aware of where we are. You are aware of our condition and our position. And so we believe and trust you, Lord. Now we ask that you will continue to lay upon our heart now so that we can reach out to those who have already made their petition known to you, to provide resources and help, to tide them over in this moment of need and in this moment of uncertainty in the name of Jesus. Just like the nations, Lord, the leaders that are in some of these states are asking faith leaders and churches to reach out to help the hungry, to help those that have no food and those that have no gasoline and those that have no lights and those that have no TV. We're asking you and those that have no air conditioning, God, whatever the necessity is, we're asking that you will bless and empower us to be your hand extended into our communities and extend it into our local churches. And we ask that the love of Christ, Father, in this demonstration will bring men and women to the point of accepting Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. And we give you praise. Help those, Father, that have pride that has been given by the adversary, that have egos that have been given by the adversary, that are too proud to ask, that are too proud to reach out for help, that they will sit in hunger and sit in darkness and sit in suffering. We ask in Jesus' name, give us visions, give us dreams, give us inspiration. Lead us by your Holy Spirit so that we'll know within our church and within our communities how we can be effective for your kingdom and spreading your love in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Father, we give you praise and we give you glory for it in Jesus' mighty name. We also pray, Father, for those that are on jobs and those that are jobs that are pending. We pray, Father, that you will provide favor. Give those that are in position of authority and ownership of corporations and organizations that have also received government assistance and help for small business loans and other loans and other funds that have been given by the government to sustain them, that they will not hoard these things to themselves, but they will provide additional resources to their workers and to their employees. Give them favor. Give the church, Father, give your people the favor after the same order you gave Israel with Pharaoh, so that their needs can be met, so that their provisions will flow to them in the name of Jesus Christ. We also ask, Father, that you will put a governmental structure in place, leadership in place, that will also make certain that the trickling down of financial assistance and food and housing will reach the bottom. It will reach the people that are at the bottom of the rung, the poor, the needy, the suffering, the minorities, Father, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We also ask, Father, that you will inspire the minorities, Father. We ask that you will put it in their heart, Father, to get up and do something for themselves. Get up and go out and make waves for themselves. Whatever the fee may be, it's honest, it's fair, whatever it may be, and then for them to trust you to add more to where they are. Father, and we give you praise and we give you glory. Deliver them, Father, from apathy, from laziness, from slothfulness, from double-mindedness. Deliver them, Father, from a spirit of unwillingness to work and earn their keep. Father, we pray in Jesus' name. Let the Spirit of the Lord come upon them, Father, and let them recognize the need to be men and the need to be women of the living God. And Father, we give you praise and we give you glory. From the north, south, east, and the west, you said you would draw your people, Father. You said you would give to us the heathens for our inheritance. Wake them up, Father. Wake them up. Those that are full of apathy, that are now couch potatoes, that are just sitting on the sofa and watching TV after TV after TV and doing nothing with themselves and nothing with your kingdom. We ask that you will stir them up, Father. Alert them to the seriousness of the hour, that it is not just a crisis in the natural, but the crisis is spilling over out of the spirit realm into this physical realm and is placing demands upon every system of the earth and every system and every level in society. We ask, Father, in Jesus' name, bless them to see that the night is here, the day is far spent, and the working time is almost over. We ask you, Father, in Jesus' name, for divine supernatural intervention in the name of Jesus. Intervene, Father. Sustain your covering over your people, Father. Sustain your covering over the church, Father. Sustain your hand upon the church, Father, in the name of Jesus. Let not the wicked, Father, receive the benefit of the righteous. And let not the righteous suffer with the wicked. Sustain our health. Sustain the length of our days. Sustain our inheritance. Sustain our provision, Father. sustain our favor in every area of our life in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And oh God, we give you praise and we give you glory. We cry out to you now, Father, in Jesus' name. We understand historically, Father, that there have been nations and there have been times and there have been generations and centuries before us that had their time as we're having our time. But I pray in Jesus' name that as you brought your people through from one century to the next, one generation to the next, from one time to the next, bring the church through in this hour and make us that bright and shining city upon the hill once again. Make us that light, that beacon light in a dark place in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let the power and the supernatural provision of God to obtain, let wealth and power be transferred to our hands even in this time and this day in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And oh God, we give you praise and we give you glory. Give us creative ideas, means and ways in which to sustain the church and sustain ourselves, our family and children and grandchildren and those who we have come to recognize as saints of the Most High God. Father, we join faith with the intercessors all over the globe right now that are praying for the same thing, that supernatural provision for the missionary, supernatural provision, Father, for the outreach ministry, supernatural provision, Father, for the traveling evangelist, supernatural provision, Father, for those all over the world that are planting seeds for the kingdom of the living God in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Father, we give you praise for those that are complacent and those that are lukewarm, Father. We pray that the Spirit of the Lord will come upon them and the fire of God will raise them up once again and inspire them, Father, to do what you have born and birthed them to do in the name of Jesus. Let the Spirit of Elijah, let the Spirit of Moses, let the Spirit of the prophets come upon us, Father, and let the prophetic word begin to utter in our prayer life, utter in our ministry life. Make us, Father, a beacon light, a living epistle, walking upon this, exemplifying the very character and nature of God in everything that we do. And we give you praise for it, and we give you glory. And for those that will hate us without a cause, and those that will hate us because we are praying these prayers, and those that will hate us because they disagree with the God that we serve, Father, in Jesus' name, stand up for our help. God, be an enemy to our enemy, an adversary to our adversary. Give revelation, insight, and knowledge to those that hunger and thirst and seek after it. And Father, we give you praise and we give you glory. Now in Jesus' name. And finally, Father, for those that are integrated and mixed throughout the crowds that are peacefully marching, we pray, Father, that you will anoint the agenda and that the agenda will be achieved, Father, and that the grace of the Lord and the Spirit of the Lord, Father, will bring a glorious end to this matter. And we also pray, Father, that you will have that a supernatural sustaining of life and health will also rest upon the crowd, that the COVID-19 will go absolutely nowhere, that it will not rise in its number and its head count and its infection nor in its death in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We pray in Jesus' name that the bloodthirsty individuals now will cease in their success and they will fail in all that they do in the name of the Lord Jesus, and the peaceful protesters, their dreams, their goals, and their agendas will be achieved nationwide and worldwide, yeah, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And God, we give you praise for it, and we give you glory for it now, in Jesus' name, amen.